Thank you. Well, I haven't skied on his skis yet because his bindings I'd have to adjust them. So. But he skied both and he said those are appreciably better than these and how these are good skis.
It's a super stiff ski.
Yeah. Yeah, my failing in skiing is that I don't turn very well. I have a tendency to go straight all my life.
Yeah, still? This is going all your life just gonna go straight down?
At some point in time I decided it better slow down and start turning a little
bit. Yeah.
And these things offer that ability to turn.
There you go.
Big turns on this ski.
I kind of learned the same way, like when I learned I just flew down the mountain.
Yeah.
And I still do it, but now I like try to focus a little bit more on just on the turning. It helps.
Yeah, I'm trying to make myself a better skier by practicing turning instead of just
flying down. How long you skied for?
Well, yeah, I started skiing in 84.
Okay.
But it's just a little bit here, a little bit there.
Yeah.
Then I went for about 10, 12 years. I didn't ski at all.
Oh.
We just started skiing just a little bit, several years ago.
Yep. So. Got it. Where are you from?
Well, we're originally from Texas. We live here in Vail now. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But
nice.
That being said, I still only been out here probably. Huh?
Where are you from?
East Vail. East Vail. Up on
Rocky Club?
No, we have a large home up on the side of a mountain. Go down Bighorn Mountain, just heading east, and turn left on Columbine.
Little
street that winds up there.
Yeah.
Very few people know that's there.
What brought you here?
Pardon?
What brought you here?
We still have our very good friends have owned a townhouse here since 84. They invited us, we were from Texas, so they invited us up here one summer about 4 years ago. And God,
I've
it was.
I've never been here in summer.
Oh, shit.
It's amazing, right?
Oh, hell. That's when you want to come. And so
really?
It was so nice. We left 100 degree temperatures in Texas. Came up here in like maybe mid 70s, low 80s or so. Lots of stuff to do. And we liked it. So very shortly after we came up here, we wound up buying our house. We had two houses. And then we sold our Texas home last July and moved up here permanently. Now, even though we have our permanent home.
Where in Texas?
Austin.
My friends live there. They moved down there like 3-4 years ago. They're Russians, so they're like, they say there is like little Russian computer stuff they do. I don't know what they do.
Yeah, Austin.
But they love it there.
Do they?
Yeah.
You know, it's Austin is predominantly a young person's town. Obviously,
yeah,
University
I've
of
been
Texas
there before.
I've been there
for a bachelor party.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's a young person's town.
Yeah. And especially downtown, my son's 31. He lives.
Yeah.
He's got a house down off of South.
LA
love it. They off of South Congress. You got all the restaurants and bars. Then you go back into 6th Street or so, and got even more. So they like it. I mean, for us, I'm an older person. I'm not into the bar scene, so it didn't really interest me a whole lot. You sure like it.
Nice.
You got music. Live.
Oh, yeah.
South by Southwest.
Yeah,
so.
A lot of music down there.
It's a good place. If you live in Texas, that's probably the best city in Texas. You still got the goddamn brutal summers, and the winters are not a whole lot better. It's it'll be as cold, but it's damper, and you walk outside and 50 degrees.
I think summer in New York much worse than Texas.
I'm New York. Where are you from?
New York City.
Sam.
New York City.
Yeah. I live in Lower East Side.
Lower East Side.
Yeah, you. Nice. I used to live in Williamsburg.
Yeah.
I used to live on North 3rd and Kent.
What is that?
North 3rd and Kent I used to live on.
North 3rd. I'm on the south.
Okay.
If you know Gianda restaurant.
Okay.
It's right there. It was like the first building they built there.
You're in one of those?
Right on the water. Right
that's
there.
Where you are?